Hello everyone, so today's task will be to deploy a very basic Node.js app on Kubernetes. So before I begin, I must tell you that I have in my system Docker desktop running, as well as I have a Minikube install and kubectl installed. So we will use these to install the app. So the first thing is, let us see the app in Visual Studio Code. So here is the app. It is a basic Node.js app which is running a simple web server, which has two endpoints. One is the slash, another is slash error. So when we run this, so it will show that hello from Node.js app, and then we will try to crash it. So what we will do is, we will first build it to demonstrate the functionality on the app. So the thing I need to do is, I need to run Docker build. I will give a name, say Kubernetes Q01 and dot. So it has started the build. So let us see how much time it takes. Okay, so we can see that our app is up and our image is built. So if I go and do Docker images, we can see that kube01 is there. So what we will do, we will just run it in our local system to see what the functionalities of this app will be. Docker run, I would give a name, say kube01. I have to prefix it with --- name, and then what we will do is, we will give a port, that is -P 8080, the one it has exposed, 8080, sorry. And then I will have it with detached mode, that is -D, and with --rm to remove when the app is down. So it will just remove the container when the app is down. And the image name is kube01. So we can see with Docker PS that this app is up. So we can just go and check on localhost :8080 that this app is up and running. And if I give slash error this endpoint, so we can see it crashes. Now if I go and see, app is not there. So here, if we see docker ps, there is nothing. If we check the history, so there is nothing. So this app is now this container is now terminated, but we have the image. Now to build Kubernetes, as I told that I have all the prerequisites installed, so the thing is, I need to start the Minikube server. So what I will do is, I will run this command to deploy our source program. So it will help us to build a very simple Kubernetes, so that we can test our code and run the commands. This will be helpful. Yes, so we can see that Docker desktop has started in the Docker desktop. This is up and running, and if we go, we can check status. So it will show the status of the existing Minikube container and control planes. Everything is displayed over here. So we have everything installed right now, and now we will need to deploy our container, see our image status. If we go to Docker Hub, so here I have already updated the Cube 01 project over here, so that should not be a problem. That is the same image which I have built, so it is already pushed. What we need to do is we need to deploy this container on Minikube. So what we will do, we will go ahead and start the deployment. So this is the command I will be using. I will be replacing the hub image with and also I had given it a so yes, successful. This image is created, and now we will start. We will just check the deployments. So the command is kubectl get deployments. So we can see it is still going on, but it will be ready and available soon. We can see it is available. It is so now it is available, but the problem is that we still need to get this one exposed, because we will not be able to access this because it is running on the container. So if I do this, we can see our one pod is running. Now we need to set this pod service. We need to have a service installed on this pod to expose its service outside the container. As we did port, here we need to give the command port, and it will be passed through this guy. We need to pass this guy. So the command will be we will expose this deployment Cube 01 to a port of I will just type it because this copy paste is not good enough. So what we will do is kubectl expose deployment. Our deployment name is cub01 to the port equals to 8080, and we will give the type equals to load balancer. Those who are new with the load balancer, you can check our YouTube videos where we have explained load balancer in detail, and there is a demo on the load balancer. So load balancer actually takes the first acts like an interface which receives all the request for its service and distributes it in the pods. So what happens is that after distribution, if it finds one pod busy, it can distribute it to another pod. So there must be multiple pods. We will be coming on it later, how to expose multiple pods through load balancer. That is, one app will be running in multiple servers, or I would rather say multiple pods, and the load will be equally distributed among them. And the finesse of this one is that if one node is down, it will spin up another pod to replace that one. So that will give us a uptime of 100%. So I am exposing the pod now. It would take some time before we can see it, so let's wait. Yes, so it is exposed. So now the thing is whenever we will expose, it will happen that because we are using Minikube, if it is on the cloud or on the actual data center where the load balancer is available, it will give it an external IP. You can see this is the CUB01. Here is the load balancer. It has given a cluster IP. This one is an internal address. And if it is deployed in the cloud having a load balancer, we can get an external IP over here. But as it is deployed on my own system, so there will be no external IP until I do one trick. And the trick is to create the service. So we will just go ahead and create a service. I am again making the same mistake, so I will not do that. Minikube, I will just see and type, that would be better. Minikube service, then we will give cube 0. So what this command will do, that it will, yes, now you can see that it has given it a service. So we can see that this is a service which is running. And here what we saw is the terminal is hijacked. So here we can see that the terminal is locked because this service has been opened. So this terminal needs to be opened to run it. We will come how to detach it from this terminal window in a later session, where we will study the finesse of these terminals and finesse of these commands, as well as how to create a deployment and others. But for now I will just have it running like this. Now if I run the command Minikube dashboard, another thing will happen. So I have started this command, and now what you will see, that yes, so it is just preparing a dashboard, and it will open another window. Here a dashboard will launch. Yes, so this is the Kubernetes dashboard on my home system, and here we can see one pod is running, and here the details is, this is the deployment, this is the replica. We will be discussing the replica. So here Kubernetes is running and everything is on, and this image ID is there, so you can see this dashboard. Now what we can do is, we can just, you know, as we have demonstrated earlier, we can pass this endpoint to the app. So it has crashed. Here in the dashboard, you can see that it has gone red. So this is because we have deliberately crashed, but just wait for some time and see what happens. Yes, so this deployment has again turned green. That means this service is running. Yes, so this is the fault tolerance that is inbuilt with the load balancer, so that if one pod crashes, it will bring up another pod and the application is always available. Note that this pod is running only on this Minikube container. It is not creating another container. So this is the basis of the Kubernetes, so that we can attach multiple containers to it. We can attach multiple containers to it when this is overwhelmed. But that aspect we will discuss later. For now, this is the video. So we have seen how to deploy a Kubernetes cluster on your machine, on your home PC, and test your app. Thank you.